So I grew up in a very, very abusive household with my mentally ill mother who was unmedicated. I first reported that abuse when I was in seventh grade. I went to my teacher and I told them that I was being abused, and so they called DCFS. And in my household, I was expected to earn straight A's or else I would receive further abuse. And so, of course, I had straight A's because you have to do what you have to do to survive. And the DCFS looked at me, they looked at my grades, they laughed in my face and said, "Kids with straight A's aren't abused." I was afraid at that point. I was at such a low point, I didn't really see an escape. So I thought she was either going to kill me or I was going to kill myself. And I didn't want to die. So from word of mouth, I had heard about a shelter in my town. And I ran away. And that's how I became homeless. It could have been prevented if we had had better training for the DCFS, just better systems set up there to help abused children get through it.
I experienced homelessness after aging out of the foster care system. So I aged out of foster care at age 21 in Washington, D.C. So if you can offer services above 21 or after 21, that could have prevented my homelessness experience.
During my times of homelessness, I lived in cars, in dirty motels, in tents, in ditches, and different homeless shelters. I moved between every 1 to 5 days for a period of 7 months. DHHS could have offered more equitable and accessible supports to my family, such as food stamps, housing vouchers, clothing, as well as Christmas and holiday donations. These things could have made a difference in my life.
When it comes to addressing youth issues, youth voice and representation are extremely important. Lived experience from youth is the key. It can incorporate so many different views, outlooks, and just overall assist in a huge way. With me having lived experience, I was able to assist them in a great way with bringing in new programming ideas, just overall giving advice on issues that they needed assistance with.
I work with a group of individuals that have dealt with their own situations, and you know, it can be similar in some ways, but they bring their own experiences to the table in order to make things happen. That's something to be proud of.
When I began the council back in 2016, I was really nervous. I was really unaware of what my circumstances meant for me. And overall, I thought what I went through was horrible and it wasn't gonna, you know, serve a purpose in my life. And I didn't learn what that purpose was until I joined the council. And then 4Y gave me a platform to express myself and command the attention of people who have the power to make changes in this nation. I honestly feel like without the National Youth Advisory Council, I wouldn't be who I am today.
My name is Darla Bardine, and I have the privilege of serving as the executive director of the National Network for Youth. We're an over 40-year-old nonpartisan policy advocacy organization dedicated to the prevention and eradication of youth and young adult homelessness and human trafficking in the U.S. We do that by speaking truth to power, to change systemic barriers, and to modify federal policies that keep young people on the outside of the housing and services that they need, and instead ensure that they not only have access, but they're also prioritized for what they need. We're also disseminating best practices so that communities and providers have the tools and resources they need to implement the most innovative and the most effective practices that young people need. The National Network for Youth believes that no young person should ever spend one day homeless in America.